Hello, all of you. My name is Hakan Cullberg. I'm an architect, an entrepreneurial architect, and I'm going to present to you my latest initiative that we have taken. And first, I want to show you some examples of some projects that I have completed already. First, we have this huge multiplex cinema, Halls of the Mountain King. It took me 20 years from idea to a finalized project. 20 years. That's crazy. But we succeeded in the end. And now it's a success. And my next project is that I took the initiative to build a new entrance and premises for a Hasselblad Foundation and the Hasselblad Center, and also it was the Sten Olsson Foundation for Culture and Science. It was founded due to this project. And it was an initiative 9 years before, and it took 9 years to finalize the project. It was a short period of time. 9 years is not that much. And it's a success as well. It is also, as we also, earlier talked about, at the square of Götaplatsen. And this is my smallest project. It's a pier building, the Eagle, at Lindholmen, at the Göta River in the middle of Gothenburg. It's not much more than a stair on the tower, but it's a building that... It's a think tank. It's the first ever built think tank, a meeting place in Sweden. And now to my huge and latest project. It's a bit too much, but but I started and grown up in scale. This is the former harbor of free trade, and this is the old city and the existing bridge and the Göta River. King Adolphus the Great founded Göteborg in 1621, and the city in nearly 250 years was not much more than this one. I say it's a half city, and they have the river there, and it's a wall grave, and you have some quays here for unloading and unloading goods. 250 years like that, and then the Industrial Revolution came and the city exploded. They built very, very much city in a very short period of time. And I want to fulfill the project. This is the half city. I want to build the rest of the circle on the other side of the river. And I also want to build an icon building, a symbol for freedom and entrepreneurship in Sweden. We want to take the position to not build the tallest building as in Calatrava designed in Malmö. And now it's a chicken race between Gothenburg and Stockholm, who will build the highest one. I say that it's not the height that is important. It's the presence and identity of the building that's important. This project started when I met a guy called Håkan Lagergren in 1993, almost 20 years ago. We had an idea to build a Viking museum in Gothenburg region. And we started to do an investigation. We had every municipality people involved, but we didn't succeed with the project. But now I have presented an information place about the Viking Age area. It's an information hub to find ideas where to go. If you come from China and go to Gothenburg, this is the place where you can understand where are all these museums and historic sites in the Nordic region, not only in Gothenburg. So we take that position. Now we are on the so-called banana pier, walking towards the cube. It's situated on a level 9 meters above the quay level. And now we have come up in one of the first levels, and are climbing up to the entrance hall. The first entrance hall is a reception room for Gothenburg, as I propose, where the municipality can meet with the government delegations and where they can give away Medal of Honors to the citizens of Gothenburg. And on the sixth floor above, we have a flexible solution where you can alter the plan regarding different functions, developments. It's a building for the young entrepreneurs who will create and build our new companies and build prosperity in Sweden, regarding also, of course, green solutions. In the background, you can see the crane from the wharf, Götaverken. When you have come up on the high level, 9 meters above, you have a fantastic view over the city, and you can walk around the building. If you don't go up, as the lady there, climb up the stairs to the entrance, you can walk on the quay, and there you have cafes and restaurants, and then inside those two floors, you have the information hub I talked about. And here is a fantastic view over the old city. We are now in the new city, and you are overlooking the old city. Now we are in the front of the cube, and you can see the stairs going down in the water, almost as in Venice. And the water is going up and down, and this is a concrete construction with stone as a layer. And you have pillars, and the water can go up and down, and don't lift the quay if the water arises. And we know that it will be. It will do that in the future. And also in front of here, you have of the building, we have a huge stairs as in front of the Art Gothenburg Art Museum, not overlooking the avenue, but overlooking the harbor and a fantastic view of the city. Here you can see it again. To the right, you have the Ralph Erskine building that was Skanska head office. And we also propose to build a special quay with a viewpoint where you can take a picture and send it on Facebook and say that you have been there. This is a plan of the whole city. It's a model in scale 1:1000. It's quite small. The houses are only 1 centimeter wide, but it is a presentation of the new city. You can see canals and the quays. We have widened the quays with filling out in the water. And the quarters are not orthogonal and rectangular, but they are in different angles because we want the city to develop in small steps. And in the back here, we have a new canal. The Killeback Canal is we have digged it, a new canal out in the river. And we have 25 high-rise buildings, almost high, 100 meters high and 30 floors. And this is the new skyline of Gothenburg, the new Gothenburg. We say in Sweden, we call it Det Nya Göteborg, and we also call it Viking Green City. That's a working name of the project. To the left, you have the new Gothenburg on the Hissing Island, and to the right, you have the old city. And they work together, almost like yin and yang, the dark city and the light city, the future city, the old city. With new materials, it's a green city, it's a dense city, it's a sustainable city in every means, social, economic, and ecological. And this is a detail, a simple drawing of how the canals can be, what they can look like. And we want the Dutch people to come back and build the city once more. They have proved it before. As you can see, it's a green city. You have trees on the canals, on the quays, and you have the roof, sloped roofs, and on the fourth and fifth floor we have a green area where you can grow your tomatoes or and so on. So this is a green city. We have we have seven different parks and different sizes in the whole area. And the project is 1 million square meters, and it holds 15,000 inhabitants and 15,000 working places. It holds everything that is in the old city: theaters, meeting places, shops, restaurants, everything. And this is a detail where you can see the new city and the icon building in the front, and the old city and the Fartygsmuseet, as we call it, a ship's museum. That is quite fantastic. And this is the building in the night, the icon building. It's almost like a beacon shining up in the night. And if you fly with an airplane, come to Landvetter, you overlook the city, and right in the middle you can see that lighting point, the cube, celebrating that it has happened something new in Gothenburg. The symbol of freedom and enterprise in Sweden. We have many people. This is the Minister of Housing. He has seen the project, and he said in Swedish, "Sätt igång och bygg." He wants to start again immediately, but he has not the position to say that because he's in the government. It's a local project. And then we have a support from the Swedish Institute, who promote the Swedish design and architecture internationally. And they say that our project is the best city planning project we have today in Sweden. We have a huge presentation in media. And here the king himself stands on his square and point at the new city of Gothenburg. Thank you.